It is time to talk playoff hockey with former Golden Knight and our resident hockey expert, Deryk Engelland. There's nothing like the Stanley Cup playoffs, Chris.
And good evening. It is once again Monday. Time to face off with Deryk Engelland. We're excited to welcome our hockey expert back on a Monday to talk postseason hockey. Deryk, I cannot believe that the postseason is already here.
Yeah, it feels like the season just started like a month ago. So for it to be here, it's an exciting time of year. It's the best hockey. This is what they play for all year long.
Is there a little bit of nervousness knowing that last year they had trouble scoring? And you look at they didn't even get a goal last night over 60 minutes of play. It's almost, nervousness perhaps.
Yeah, I don't know. I think it's just, they're going to have to get those greasy goals. They go to the blue paint, one goes off you, or rebound goals. They're going to have to battle down there. You got to win those blue paint battles in both ends, in front of our goalie and in front of theirs. And maybe it was just from outside just a little too much last night.
You mentioned it too. They got to find more ways to score the puck.
Yeah, like I said, it's going to be, instead of looking for that pretty goal, it's going to be a greasy one. It's going to be a shot from the point. Maybe it goes off someone's leg and in, and those are the goals that come in playoff time. You look at their game-winning goal, it's a turnover leads to a pass out front off someone to another guy, and Marty goes down to block and hits his foot and deflects to the other side. So that's a greasy goal. That's a playoff goal, though.
I was looking at that game last night. You think Marc-Andre Fleury probably played his best game of the season, and all for naught when you think about just how fabulous he was and you couldn't get the win for him.
Yeah, that's, he's been lights out all year, and like you said, that was one of his best outings for sure. And that's all a goalie can do. He keeps it a 0-0 game and going into overtime and making those big key saves at key times and kept them in it. So, you just want him to keep going like that.
Boy, can they win this thing without Pacioretty, leading scorer? It's going to be tough, isn't it, taking a hole like that?
Like I said, you got to go get those greasy goals. But, they're definitely missing him, not only on with Stoney there, but the power play. He's such a threat. His shot's so good. That's a tough guy to match up against.
What did you see in that overtime? Let's go right to the overtime, 3:20, I think it was, or whatever, when they scored in the overtime. But how did you kind of see that whole play unfolding?
Yeah, I think, I didn't see it up close, but, Petro comes around the net, and it looks like the puck rolls over a stick as he's shooting it, so it kind of whiffs on it a little bit. And just turnover, it's unfortunate, bad ice overtime, and then it just makes a pass out front. Foligno misses it, and it ends up going right to Eriksson-Ek, and from there Marty's scrambling and tries to block the shot, which he's done all season, blocking those shots, and just takes a fortunate bounce and sneaks by Flower.
All right, well, the next time we talk, they'll be either they got swept the Golden Knights, which I can't even fathom, or we'll be talking about Game 5 a week from today.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure probably Game 5. this one's going to be a good series. It's going to be a battle. It's going to go deep into the series.
All right, so don't forget, tomorrow we got Game 2 at the Fortress. You'll be there, Deryk. It's going to be exciting. 7 o'clock. We'll be on the Plaza. Come by and say hello.